Hello, good morning student. Today in the chapter periodic property, we will discuss the next property, electron affinity. The term electron affinity means electron gain. Okay. In the previous topic about ionization enthalpy, I explained you all that the amount of energy required to remove an electron from the outermost shell of an isolated gaseous atom. But here, electron affinity is just opposite of ionization enthalpy. It is the amount of energy released when an extra electron is added in an isolated gaseous atom to form an anion. Here, so I mean whatever energy is required to add an extra electron in the outermost shell of an atom is called as electron affinity, right? Let us consider the example chlorine. Atomic number of chlorine is 17, electronic configuration is 287. So to achieve octet, chlorine requires one electron. Okay, so in this way we talk about electronic configuration or orbit diagram of chlorine, K shell, L shell and M shell. K shell containing 2 electron, L shell 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, while M cell is containing 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 electron. One additional electron is required to complete the octet of chlorine atom. So whatever energy will release while you are adding an extra electron in the outermost shell of chlorine, that will be called as electron affinity. I hope you understood. Always remember, electron affinity EA is an interbonding process. It is an exergonic process. Right? Exergonic means delta H will be negative. Right? Why delta H is negative here? Because energy releases when extra electron is added in outermost shell of an isolated gaseous atom. Right? While successive electron affinity is an interbonding process. Do you know why successive electron affinity is an interbonding process? Because successive means, I hope you people are aware, successive means when in the row we add the electron. Suppose one electron you have added, again you are adding extra electron to the outermost shell. So this is called as successive. Clear? So successive electron affinity is intergonic because when another electron is added in the outermost shell, the electron feels repulsion. So to overcome that repulsion, we have to supply energy. That's why process is intergonic. Intergonic means endothermic. Exergonic means exothermic. Now come at trains of electron affinity. trends of electron affinity down the group and across the period. If you talk about trends in electron affinity across the period, right? Electron affinity increases across the period. Why electron affinity increases across the period? Because I hope you people know, nuclear charge increases. Nuclear charge increases and atomic size are decreases. When we move top to bottom in a group, electron affinity decreases. Why electron affinity decreases? Because R increases. Understood? Always remember, electron affinity is dependent on atomic size R and nuclear charge. Okay, let us see the explanation for it. When we move top to bottom in a group, the value of R increases. When R will increase, the distance between the nucleus and outermost cell will increase, and it will cause the less attraction between the nucleus and electron. Right now, when there will be less attraction between the nucleus and electron, it is not easy to gain the electron. Means nucleus will not pull electron in the outermost shell. Right now, so electron affinity will decrease here. Right now, while in case of across the period, electron affinity increases. Why electron affinity increases? Because R decreases. R here decreases. When R will decrease, the distance between the nucleus and outermost cell will also decrease, and that will result in the attraction of electron in the outermost cell. That's why electron affinity increases across the period. I hope you people understood today's topic, electron affinity. Thank you.